right? So we are starting with the introduction. What is a filter? We have heard this name so many times, so we know what is this, right? So what do you mean by a filter? Anyone, can you, anyone tell what do you mean by a filter? Because we have come across this name many times, is it not? Right, a filter is a, it is also a circuit, which we can call it as a frequency selective circuit, which will allow signals of a particular band of frequency and attenuate another band of frequency. So that is what we call as filter, right? So a filter is capable of passing a certain frequencies and it will reject other frequencies. In the sense, it will attenuate signals of a particular band of frequencies. And active filters, see, we are going to deal active filters, right? So what is a passive filter and what is an active filter? A passive filter is a filter which is built, that is the circuit will be designed using only the passive components like resistors, inductors and capacitors. An active filter, of course, it should be a filter which is built, which is designed using an active component along with the passive components also, of course. An active component can be either a transistor or an op-amp. And in this case, it can be either FET also. It can be even FET. Okay, some active component. And here we are going to deal, since we are dealing with analog circuits, specifically with op-amps, we are going to see filters using op-amps. So, of course, along with that, it will have some passive components also, like resistors, RC combination, RL combination, or an RLC combination, anything. Right? And in a filter, what are the basics we should know? Let me use a pointer. So what are the basic concepts we should know in a filter? So in a filter, we have certain terminologies like pass band, stop band, critical frequency, transition region, all those things. So we'll see what is it. A pass band, okay, for any filter, what type, whatever may be the type of the filter, any filter, we have a band in the response, in the frequency response, which we call it as the pass band. So a pass band is nothing but it is a set of frequencies, a range of frequencies, which are allowed to pass through the filter with minimum attenuation. Actually speaking, it should not have any attenuation, but practically speaking, there will be minimum attenuation. Okay, so the range of frequencies over which the signal can pass through the circuit with minimum attenuation is called as the pass band. And of course, then what must be the stop band? The range of frequencies over which the signals can pass through the filter with maximum attenuation. Okay, it should be infinite attenuation, actually speaking. The signal should be completely cut off. But again, practically speaking, we'll be having a minimum amount of signal flowing through the circuit. And therefore, we call that to be maximum attenuation. Okay, and then comes a terminology called as critical frequency. So what do you mean by this critical frequency? It is the, we can also call this as cutoff frequency. Okay, so it is between the pass band and the stop band. It is the frequency, we can say it is the frequency which cuts off, which segregates the pass band and the stop band, right? So a single frequency will be called as a cutoff frequency, and usually it will be a point which is 70.7% of the maximum gain, right? So when we draw the, when we try to get the frequency response of any filter, whatever is the maximum gain from that, 70.7%, or we can 0.707 of the maximum gain, or in dB, we can put it as -3 dB from the maximum gain. Okay, so that particular point, we call it as the critical frequency or cutoff frequency. Right. Then what is called as the transition region? That is, ideally speaking, for any filter, the signal should be completely allowed during the pass band and it should be completely stopped during the stop band. In that case, we will not have anything called as transition region. That is, exactly at cutoff frequency, you'll be having a transition either from the pass band to the stop band or from stop band to the pass band, depending on what type of filter we are designing. But practically speaking, this will not happen. We'll be having a region between the pass band and the stop band where the signal will be frequency response will be transiting from one state to the other state, that is from one region to the other region, either from passband to stopband or from stopband to passband. You will not have a precise point where it will be differentiating the passband and the stopband as we have in the ideal case. So that region only we call it as the transition region, right? So these are the terminologies we should be familiar with. Next. Now, what are the different filter responses we'll be able to get? There are some basic filter responses which we'll be usually using with you would have built already using transistors, okay, or with only with passive components you would have learned in circuits, right? Same thing. We have something called as low pass filter, and then high pass filter, band pass filter, band stop filter, all these things. Of course, from the graph you can easily find out, you can easily define what do you mean by each and every type of these filters. So low pass filter, as the graph is shown, it will allow lower band of frequencies from zero till the cutoff frequency. You'll be having the stop band, and after this you'll be having the stop band. So now you can see this is an ideal filter, right? That's why you don't have any transition region here. You have a sharp cutoff from the pass band to the stop band. Exactly, it will happen at the cutoff frequency or the corner frequency. Even you can call this as the corner frequency. Okay, so this is the frequency which differentiates the pass band and stop band. Okay, for all types of filters. So this is for low pass. High pass, it will pass only the high frequency signals. So low frequencies from zero, all the lower frequencies will be having maximum attenuation. In this case, infinite attenuation. That's why the signal is zero. And after the cutoff frequency, you'll be having minimum attenuation. In this case, since again it is ideal, you'll be having the entire signal passing through this, right? And this is your cutoff frequency, the transition part, okay? And bandpass filter means a filter which will allow a band of frequency. So you'll be having two cutoff frequencies here, right? So the signal will be allowing filter will be allowing signals only between the cutoff frequencies. So between these two cutoff frequencies, the filter will allow the signals to pass through it. Any signal of lower frequency than this cutoff will be attenuated. Similarly, signals having frequency higher than this higher cutoff will be attenuated. So on either sides, the signals will get attenuated, and only this band of signal will be passed through the filter. This is called as band pass. And finally, band stop. So what is a band stop filter? Band stop filter is the reverse of this. A band of frequencies will be attenuated. So for this band of frequencies, between the two cutoff frequencies, you'll have maximum attenuation. On either side, you'll be having minimum attenuation, right? So this is what we call it as band stop filter. So these are some basic filter responses what we can build, right? So next is now how the filter response is decided, on what factors it depends on. Okay, so these are some basic informations we should know. So when you talk about the filter response, the response of any filter depends upon the number of RC terms it contains, the number of RC components it contains in the circuit, because the number of RC components in the circuit decides the number of poles in the transfer function of a circuit that has been designed. And the number of poles in the transfer function decides the roll-off rate, or we can say decides the transition region of a filter, right? So very important is how many resistors and capacitors we are going to use in the circuit what we are designing, whatever may be the filter, whether you are designing a low pass filter or a high pass filter or band pass or whatever may be the filter, how many RC combinations we are going to use in the filter, that matters. So based on the number of RC combinations in the circuit we are designing, you will be getting number of terms in the denominator. Okay, so if you have only one RC combination, then you'll be having only one term in the denominator, like S minus some value will be there, okay, or Z minus something will be there in the if it is a digital one. Okay, anyway, we are dealing with analog. So it is, you'll be having the transfer function as H of S is equal to A divided by S minus A. Okay, A can be any value. This basic the pole value, basically the pole value. Okay, so based on the RC component, what we have in the circuit, we'll be having that many terms in the denominator. So number of terms in the denominator, the order of the denominator leads to the number of poles for the circuit, and the number of poles for the design circuit decides the transition width of the transition region of a filter, and how much it is closer to the ideal filter response. Okay, so here if you see, it has been given that if you have a single RC pair in the circuit what we have designed, then we'll be having only one pole in the denominator, and therefore the filter what we have designed will have a transition width, that is, will have a transition region where the signal, where the response will be rolling at a rate of minus 20 dB per decade. Okay, this is a standard one, right? You would have already learned in control systems regarding this, right? We can derive this in Bode plot and all. You would have derived this and say, so when you have one pole in the denominator, it will lead to a roll-off rate of minus 20 dB per decade, right? It is very slow, right? And this roll-off rate is not a good filter characteristic. As I said, it is very slow, is it not? Ideally speaking, but at one particular frequency, you should have the transition from passband to stopband or stopband to passband. But here we are having a roll-off rate of minus 20 dB per decade, which is very slow, okay? And therefore, it is not a desirable characteristic, okay? Now, whatever I have told till now it is shown as a graph. I think you can understand now better, right? For example, we are first starting with a low-pass filter response. So how a low-pass filter response will be? It should allow lower frequencies and it should attenuate higher frequencies. Okay, so suppose if this is my cutoff frequency FC, all signals below this should be having minimum attenuation. So that is what's shown here. You'll be having a flat gain in this region. And after my cutoff frequency, I'm supposed to have the stop band. It means, ideally speaking, I'll be having something like this as the graph. Okay, here it should immediately come down. And after this, the signal should be zero. But practically, this will not happen. Instead, from passband, it will go to the stop band by slowly rolling off like this. Okay, this reduction, I mean, this changeover, it happens at a speed of minus 20 dB per decade. See how slow it is transiting from the passband to the stop band. So by the time it reaches stop band, so much of frequencies are in the transition region. So after this range of frequencies only, the filter response will go to the stop band, right? So you have such a big transition region when you have single RC pair in the circuit. So when, for example, this is not an active filter, a basic low pass filter, okay? Basic low pass filter, nothing but a combination of R and C, and the output should be taken across the capacitor, right? So this is our basic low pass filter circuit with the passive components. And this is how I'll be getting the graph for this. Since I have one pair, it will be rolling at a rate of minus 20 dB per decade. Okay. So how can you get the expression for this? Right. So it is, the transfer function is equal to output by input. So you have to write the expression for Vout, and then you have to write expression for Vs. Then take it as V naught of S by V of Vi of S. So you'll be getting an expression like this, 1 by SC divided by R plus 1 by SC. Just because it is a analog circuit, we have taken Laplace transform here. So this will lead to 1 divided by 1 plus SC. Just simplify this, you'll be getting it as 1 divided by 1 plus SC. Simple calculation here, okay? Right, so this is the transfer function, and the cutoff frequency can be derived as FC will be equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. Okay, so cutoff frequency FC will be equal to 1 by 2 pi RC, and the bandwidth of this filter will be equal to from 0 till this cutoff frequency, 0 to FC. So it is FC minus 0, which will be equal to FC. So bandwidth is FC, and FC value is this, and this is the transfer function. Okay, so this is for a single pole low pass filter. Okay, suppose if it is a high pass filter. Now how the response will be? for a high pass filter? For a high pass filter, the response will be somewhere like, you can see how a filter will look like. Can you find the difference between the previous one and this one? Just you can compare that with this. Yes. Again, I have one resistor component and one capacitor component. That's it, right? So now, the order in which it has been connected alone, you can see a difference. First, you'll be having a capacitor and then you'll be having a resistor, and output is taken across the resistor. That is the case, then this combination will act as a high pass filter, a basic passive high pass filter circuit. Okay. Now, I have to get the response for this. Okay, so when I give an input to this, when I try the transfer function of this, again, I have to write the transfer function output by V naught. Transfer function is equal to output by input. Write the expression for output and input. Simplify in Laplace transform again. Then you'll be getting the transfer function. Again, you have a cutoff frequency. See the graph here. Now, since it is a high pass filter, initially you should have maximum attenuation, and then slowly it should start allowing the signal to pass through this. So this is my cutoff frequency. So ideally speaking, my graph should go like this. From here, it should be zero, and immediately it should raise here, and then it should be high. But practically, again, it will not happen. Slowly, it will be allowing the signals to pass through. So you have a transition region here again. So this transition region is again at a rate of minus 20 dB per decade. So the speed at which it is transiting from one band to the other band is again, now in this case, it is from stop band to pass band. Previous, it is pass band to stop band. Now it is stop band to pass band. And again, it is increasing at a rate of minus 20 dB per decade because you have only one RC pair here. Suppose I have two RC pairs, what will happen? Just think. See, I was talking only about one RC pair. And for one RC pair, I said you'll be having a roll-off rate, a change, a speed in the rate of minus 20 dB per decade, is it not? Now, what will be, suppose if I have two RC pairs in my circuit, there is a second order filter. So this is called as first order filter. Since you have only one S term in the denominator, one pole in the denominator, the order of the transfer function will come to one. I can show you in the previous case, this is my transfer function. Okay. So I can write this as in terms of S plus 1 by S plus 1 by RC. Is it not? I can rearrange this and write it in the form of S minus or S plus something. So in that case, what happens? I have only one term in the denominator. I have to take LCM here and do that. Okay. When I have only one term in the denominator, which is S plus 1 by RC, simplifying this, I'll get this. Is it not? Just take S common outside here. You'll be get, sorry, RC common outside here. I'll be getting S plus 1 divided by RC. Is it not? So the order of this transfer function will be equal to 1. So that is why it's called as first order filter, right? Suppose if I have two RC components here, then I'll be getting two S terms here. Okay. S plus something into S plus the second thing, S plus A1 into S plus A2. So when you get like that, it means I have two S terms, and therefore the order of the transfer function goes to 2. It is a second order filter. In that case, my roll-off rate will be, this one term will lead to minus 20 dB per decade. One more one term will lead to minus 20 dB per decade. And on the whole, it goes to minus 40 dB per decade. That is what you can see here. Suppose if I increase, instead of minus 20 dB per decade, if I have two RC pairs here, then my roll-off rate will be minus 40 dB per decade. See, now the speed has increased. You can see the change in the graph, is it not? 20 dB per decade, see how slowly it is varying. Minus 40 dB means you can see the stop band region, and a little bit faster it is moving to the pass band. And if I have three RC pairs, see, it is changing at a rate of minus 60 dB per decade. So 60 dB per decade, it is even more fast, is it not? There is a fast change from one region to the other region. So as you increase, so what you can understand from this, as I increase the order of the filter, I'll have the reduction in the transition region. This is my transition region, is it not? How long it takes to move from one band to the other band. This is my transition region. So my transition region width decreases as I increase the order of the filter. And my filter response approaches the ideal response, because ideally speaking, how my graph should be? It should be zero here and immediately it should go like this, not? So I'm not getting immediately like this. Instead, it is varying like this for first order, for second order here, for third order. Just imagine if I have fourth order, fifth order, my graph will be going on like this. You can show it also. Suppose, just imagine if I have a fourth order, it will go like this. Okay, then the fifth order will be even more closer. So as in the 10th order, it will go somewhere like this. See, it is closer to the ideal response, because what ideal response will be? Ideal response should be zero here and exactly sharply it should increase. Not able to draw a straight line properly here, but it should be straight enough. Okay, so it should go like this, actually speaking. Right, so as I increase the order of the filter, I'm able to understand that my filter response approaches the ideal filter response. Okay, so this we should understand here. Right, going to the next one, a band pass filter. So again, same band pass filter response, we all know, but here instead of one cutoff frequency, we'll be having two cutoff frequencies. Yes, just a minute, let me take the pointer again. Okay, so you'll be having two cutoff frequencies you have a center frequency between these two cutoff frequencies, which we call it as F0. Okay, and this is the bandwidth of the bandpass filter. And here you have a new formula because for bandwidth in previous cases and all, we can easily directly get it from the graph. And here, since you have two cutoff frequencies, bandwidth will be the difference between the two cutoff frequencies. That will be called as the bandwidth. And the center frequency can be denoted, take it as root of FC1 into FC2. And you have a component called as quality factor here. The quality factor can be defined as the ratio of center frequency to the bandwidth. So you can see that bandwidth and quality factor are inversely proportional. As my bandwidth increases, quality factor decreases. As quality factor increases, bandwidth decreases. Okay. So Q value. So narrower the bandwidth, for narrow bandpass filter, Q value will be high. And for wide bandpass filter, Q value will be low. Okay. So you have two types of bandpass filter, wide bandpass filter and narrow bandpass filter. And Q value will be inversely. So like it is shown here, you can see. Narrow band means Q value will be greater than 10 and wide band pass filter means Q value will be less than 10. Okay. Now this is band stop filter. Band stop filter, range of frequencies is stopped here. Here you can have something called as notch filter. Band stop filter is, sorry. Band stop filter is otherwise called as band reject filter, band elimination filter. And a specific case of that is called as notch filter. What do you mean by notch filter is, somewhat I can show this graph also. A notch filter will be even more sharper like this, like you can draw and show how the response of a notch filter will be. If you take the same graph, please bear with my diagrams. It's not that very clear. Okay. If I have a filter characteristic like this, okay, this is called as notch filter. So what you can understand from this characteristic is, of course, the axis remains the same. Here you have the frequency and here you have the gain. No variation here. If I don't write anything in the axis, there is no meaning for this graph. So let me write it like this. This is frequency and gain, okay? Now, what you can understand from this graph, what has been drawn here is, this side, this is stop band. It is attenuated. All these frequency ranges are attenuated. And again, this side is again stop band. All these frequency ranges are attenuated. Okay. I'm sorry. Both the sides are pass band. You can see it is allowed. Okay. So you can see here it is allowed. Right. You have a maximum gain here. And similarly, you have a maximum gain here also. So this side is also pass band and this side is also pass band. Now, where is the stop band means? It is only at the cutoff frequency. Whatever is my cutoff frequency, only that particular frequency will be attenuated. Rest all frequencies will be allowed to pass through the filter. So that type of filter only, we call it as the notch filter. Okay, one particular frequency is being attenuated, right? Now, so till now we were discussing about different frequency responses like the low pass filter response, high pass, band stop. All these are different filter responses what we can get. And now we'll see about certain filter characteristics. A filter can be any filter, low pass, high pass, band pass, or band stop. Whatever may be the filter, it can have either Butterworth characteristics or Chebyshev characteristics or Bessel characteristics. It can have any of these characteristics, right? So what do you mean by this Butterworth characteristics, Chebyshev characteristics is? Butterworth characteristic is, if you see, the property of a Butterworth filter will is it will have a flat response. You can see it from the graph. Okay, an example, a low pass filter graph is shown here for all the three different characteristics. Let me again go back to the pointer. Right. So Butterworth is one what you can see in pink. So this is basically a low pass filter. So a low pass filter will look like this. It will allow lower frequencies, flat pass band, and then it will have a stop band after this. This is my somewhere here I'll be having my cutoff frequency, right? So this is the pink one. What is shown here is a Butterworth characteristic. Okay, what you can understand from this is the property is a Butterworth filter will have flat pass band and flat stop band. Okay, you will not have any ripples, and the roll off rate is somewhat considerable. It is not too fast, it is not too slow. It is acceptable range. So that is what Butterworth filter. Chebyshev filter, the one which is shown in green, Chebyshev filter, it will have actually a better roll off rate. Okay, that is for a given order of the filter, it will roll off fast when compared to the Butterworth filter. Okay, for the given specification, if we design a Chebyshev filter, it will roll off fast when compared to a Butterworth filter which is designed with the same specification. Okay, so you can see that again here itself. For the same specification, we have designed a Butterworth low pass filter, Chebyshev low pass filter, and a Bessel low pass filter. Right. So Butterworth first we saw what you have in pink. Chebyshev, which is in green, you can see it oscillates here and then here sharply goes down. So you can see the roll-off rate of Chebyshev is faster when compared to Butterworth. Butterworth is little slow when compared to this. Okay, but the drawback here is you will have ripples. Chebyshev, we have two types, type 1 and type 2. If it is type 1 filter, you will be having ripples in the pass band. If it is type 2 filter, you will be having ripples in the stop band. Here, you will be having ripples like this. Okay, here it will be flat. So somewhere we'll be having the ripples. You'll be having fluctuation in the response. So that is the drawback with Chebyshev, but it will have a faster roll-off rate. And finally, Bessel. Bessel characteristics is maximally flat. A flat response you'll get, but it will be too flat when compared to Butterworth. So because of that, it will have a very slow roll-off rate. You can see the blue one, what is shown here. See, slowly it is rolling off from the pass band to the stop band. Okay, for the same specification, the roll-off rate is very, very slow. Okay, so it means you'll be having a wide transition region. So that is drawback here. But you'll be having a better flat response. All right, so this is, these are some of the characteristics of filters. Like this, we can show it for a high pass, band pass, for all types of filters. Okay. Now, specifically, till now we were discussing about passive filters as an example, is it not? We saw only the circuits of passive filters. Now we'll go to the active filters. So active filters are, as I said, it will have an active element. Okay, in this case, we'll consider it as op-amp. So if you use op-amp as a active component in a filter, what are the advantages we'll have? So whatever may be the advantage of an op-amp, the same advantage holds good for the filter also. So we know what are the advantages of op-amp, is it not? Op-amp means definitely it will have very high gain, and then it will have high input impedance, so it will not have any loading of source. It will have very low output impedance, and therefore you can connect any number of loads. It has a wide frequency range, that is, it has a wide bandwidth range, and therefore you have a wide frequency response. Okay, so all these things are advantages of op-amp, which applies to the filter also, for an active filter. So for an active filter, all these advantages holds good. Now, single pole low pass filter. Okay, now already we saw this low pass filter, but we saw with only R and C component. Now I am introducing an active component and op-amp here. So this is the circuit of a single pole low pass filter. So only one pole, it means you have one RC combination. So you can see the input is given through an RC combination to the active component, and as usual you have a feedback here. Okay, so usual feedback circuit, an inverting amplifier circuit, where the input is given through an RC component, okay, RC combination. So that will act as a single pole low pass filter, and you will be getting a response like this. No, not a big change. The gain alone will be improved. Rest all will remain the same, because you can see that low pass filter characteristic should be like this only. And since you have only one RC per combination, it should roll off at a rate of minus 20 dB per decade. Okay. And when you try to derive the expression for this, you can get the transfer function of this and the expression for the cutoff frequency. As usual, the cutoff frequency will be 1 by 2 pi RC. You will not have any change in these things alone. Okay. And cutoff frequency, since this is gain in dB, from the maximum, you have to subtract 3, minus 3 dB, you have to take the cutoff frequency. And this is how we have to derive. That is, I'm trying to write an expression for V0. It is non-inverting, so 1 plus RF by R1 times the input here. Okay? Because input is given in the non-inverting non-inverting terminal, so output is 1 plus RF by R1 times, that is 1 plus the feedback amplifier divided by the input amplifier times the input here. So the input here should be calculated. What is the voltage here? So total voltage into this impedance divided by the total impedance. That is what is written here. Okay. And simplify this, your expression. This is the transfer function, where A0 is open loop gain divided by 1 plus JF by FH, where FH is the cutoff frequency, which is 1 by 2 pi RC. So from this 2 pi RC, 1 by 2 pi RC, we name it as a frequency, cutoff frequency FH. And this is the second order filter. So as we saw the first order filter there, again, a second order filter can be slightly modified here from this circuit. Since we have one RC combination, this is first order filter, a single pole filter. Now you have two RC combination, two resistors, two capacitors, okay, RC combination. And this is one more RC combination. If you connect like this, this will act as the Salen key. Second order low pass filter is otherwise called a Salen key low pass filter. Okay, and it is also called as a voltage controlled voltage source. It will act as an voltage source which is controlled by the input voltage. Okay, so the output voltage is controlled by the input voltage. Therefore, this is called as voltage controlled voltage source. Okay. And as we have gone to the second order filter, of course, we'll be having a better transition region, the better roll-off rate, the speed would have been increased, it will approach towards the ideal filter, and the cutoff frequency will be of this formula, 1 by, previous case it is 1 by 2 pi RC, is it not? Now in this case, since you have two resistors and two capacitors, the formula will come like this, root of RARB and CACB. If we choose all these resistors and capacitor values as equal, that is these two resistor values equal, and these two capacitor values equal, then in that case, our value comes, I mean, the formula comes as FC is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC, right? Similarly, for high pass, okay, same thing. Just you can have a glance. Both single pole and Salen key, that is two pole, is shown here. See what is the difference here. For the low pass and high pass. Now, band pass. A wide band pass filter can be constructed by combining a low pass filter and high pass filter, by cascading a low pass and high pass filter, we'll be able to build a wide band pass filter, not a narrow one, wide band pass filter. So you can see, first it should be a high pass filter and then it should be a low pass filter. Okay, you can either build a single pole band pass filter or a second order band pass filter. Okay, first order or second order. Now this is a second order because you can see this is second order high pass filter circuit and this is second order low pass filter circuit. Both are cascaded. Cascaded in the sense the output of the first one will be the input of the second one. So this logic is very simple. You can get it from the graph. See, this is the normally a graph of a band pass filter, right? So I can divide this graph into two. In the center, if I put a line, the first graph looks like here. You can see that it is coming like this and then it is increasing, right? So this graph looks like a high pass filter. And similarly, the second half, initially it is allowing the signal and then it is not allowing the signal. So it looks like something like a low pass filter. So the combination of this high pass and this low pass put together, only we are getting the graph of this band pass filter. And the same thing is done in the circuit also. So I'm combining a high pass and then a low pass, then it will act as a wide band pass filter. Okay, so the bandwidth is the difference between the two cutoff frequencies. Since it is second order, you'll have a decade of minus 40 dB per decade speed here as well as here because both are second order. Okay, and this is how we'll be writing the expression for the cutoff frequencies. Okay, you can have a glance for this also. Now we'll see a few problems. Okay, now this is a very simple problem with respect to filters. Okay, your question is design a second order high pass Butterworth filter having cutoff frequency of 5 kilohertz. So what are the informations that is given in the question? I have to design a second order filter. It should be a high pass filter and it is a Butterworth filter. The cutoff frequency of the filter should be 5 kilohertz. So many informations are given in the circuit, right? Sorry, question, right? So with this given information, we have to design. So for designing a second order filter, what are the things we need? See, just well, go back to the circuit since I have not shown the circuit here. Second order high pass, right? See, this is my second order high pass circuit. So if I have to design this, what are the components values I should find? I should find what should be the value of CA, CB, RA, RB, okay, and then R1, R2. So many components I have to find the value for the given question. But mostly we'll be designing the low pass and high pass filter, second order filter, by assuming that these two capacitor values are equal and these two resistor values are equal. That is RA equal to RB and CA equal to CB. So with the same assumption only, we are going to do the problem also. So it means I have to find this R, C and this R1, R2. Right? So how to find that? First, we know the only data what is given in the question as a number, as a numerical value is the cutoff frequency. So we know what is the formula for the cutoff frequency. You can designate as you wish, F0, FC, FH, anything. Right? So the cutoff frequency formula is equal to F0 equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. See, here I have assumed that both the resistor values are equal and both the capacitor. Otherwise, the formula will be root of RA, RB, CA, CB. Is it not? Since we have assumed all the values to be equal, this is 1 by 2 pi RC, okay, which is equal to 5 kilohertz. And usually, we'll have the capacitor in the range of 0.1 microfarad. It can be, you can either choose 0.1 microfarad or 0.01 microfarad also. Something mostly it should be less than 1 microfarad, okay. The capacitor value should be less than 1 microfarad to get a better response. So usually we'll make an assumption of 0.1 or 0.01. So here we have made an assumption of 0.1 microfarad. So with this assumption, assuming C, I can find out what is R. I've got this, right? So this is R and C values. Now what else? We have to find the feedback resistors and the resistor which is connected to it to the ground, that is R1 and R2 from that circuit, okay? So for that, since it is given a second order filter and it is a Butterworth filter, in a Butterworth filter, for a second order filter, if you see the transfer function will have a value alpha in the denominator, s square plus 2 alpha s, okay, where the alpha value will be 1.414 for a Butterworth filter. Okay, so always for a Butterworth filter, alpha value will be 1.414, and the gain expression will be, gain will be equal to 3 minus alpha. Okay, so once you derive the second order filter transfer function, in that derivation will be able to get this expression. A will be equal to 3 minus alpha. Since alpha is equal to 1.414, I'll be getting the A value as 1.586, because the gain is not given here. Sometimes in the question, they will give the gain. In that case, I need not write this expression directly. I can take that as the gain. Okay, so this is C, S square plus alpha S plus, this is omega square. Okay, so this is a general expression for a second order filter. This gain expression A is equal, we know gain of a filter will be, the low pass filter or high pass filter will be 1 plus RF by RI, right? Which is equal to the value what we have found here, 1.586. So it means that RF by RI will be equal to 0.586. From that, since both are unknown, I can assume one and find the other one. Okay, so if I assume RI to be 10K, then I can find RF to be 5.86K. See, this RI and RF is nothing but these R1 and R2. Okay, instead of RI and RF, R1 and R2 is shown here. Okay, so that is this. Just go through the problem. See if you have any doubts. Able to understand this problem? Just see. Hope you don't have any doubt. It is very simple problem. If you have understood the concept properly, that you should be able to do the next problem actually. Right? We'll go to the next problem. Just read the question once and see what you are able to understand from this. Okay, what is given? A simple active filter is shown. This is a filter circuit because you have an RC combination. Assume ideal op-amp. So derive the transfer function for this, V0 by VI of the circuit, and state the type of the filter. You should say whether this is high pass or low pass. Okay. Band pass or band reject also. Determine the required values. So when you want to design this filter, it means I should find out what is the value of R1, R2, and C. Without any information, I cannot do anything, right? So some data should be given in the question. So what is given? In order for the filter to have a 3 dB frequency of 1 kilohertz. 3 dB frequency means, what do you mean by 3 dB frequency? It is the cutoff frequency. So cutoff frequency is given as 1 kilohertz. A high frequency input resistance of 100 kilo ohms. So it means at high frequency, input resistance is 100 kilo ohms. And the high frequency gain magnitude of 10. So it means magnitude is 10. Okay, with all these values, that is input impedance is given, and then gain is given. Okay, and then cutoff frequency is given. So with all these things, you should be able to find out what type of filter is this and what are the values of R1, R2, and C. Okay, so how will you find this? Just try it out. I want you people to try this, think a little bit, try it. Anyhow, I'll give you the solution also, but still first try it. And if you're able to get the answer, just post it in the chat box. Just I'll give you 3 minutes of time. You should complete this one. Okay. Completed. So, how to do this? Getting the answers. First, simple logic is, since it has been given as high input, high frequency input resistance. Okay. So, at high frequency, what will happen? This is your input impedance, the reactance will become zero. Okay, and therefore this acts as a short circuit, and therefore your impedance, input impedance will be only this R1. Okay, so input impedance, I can take this as R1, which is 100 kilo ohms. So R1 value is this 100 kilo ohms. Okay, and high frequency gain magnitude of 10. Right, so gain value has been given as 10. And cutoff frequency. Cutoff frequency is, for a high pass filter, it is, you know the formula for finding out the cutoff frequency of a high pass filter, right? So use the cutoff frequency value and find out the value of C. Using R, you can find out what is the value of C. And gain has been given as 10, since it is an inverting amplifier, because high frequency, at high frequency, you can consider this as a short circuit, and therefore the gain will be minus R2 by R1, right? So already you know what is the value of R2. So R2 by R1 is equal to 10, means from this you can find out what is R1. Sorry, R2. Is it not able to get it? See, this is an inverting amplifier. So this will simply act as an inverting amplifier at high frequency, and therefore the gain formula comes as V0 by VI will be equal to minus R2 by R1. R1 is nothing but the input impedance, which is 100K. So R2 by R1, you know what is R1, and that is equal to the value 10. Okay. So R2 divided by 100K is equal to 10, means from that you can find out what is the value of R2. Okay. It will be 100K into 10, and therefore it comes to 1 mega ohm. So R1, and this is 1 mega ohm. From the cutoff frequency formula, knowing all these resistor values, the only unknown is formula will be F is equal to 1 by 2 pi R2C. Okay, so we know value of R2. So substituting that, we can find out what is the cutoff frequency is also known. You can find out what is the value of capacitor. Yes, have you understood? Yes, few of you have got the answer. Very right. Correct, correct. Yes, if you are posted in the chat box, it is right. Hope you are able to understand. So, this is a high pass filter. Okay, it's a high pass filter. Because at high frequencies only, it will allow the signal to pass through it. Why I am concluding this as a high pass filter, just think. At low frequency, what will happen? The signal cannot pass through this capacitor, is it not? Because when the frequency is low, the impedance will be very high. So this impedance will be very high, and therefore it will act as an open circuit. So the signal cannot pass through this. So low frequency signal cannot pass through this. Only high frequency signal can pass through this, because at high frequencies, the capacitor will act as a short circuit. Okay. And therefore high frequency signals can pass through this. Is it not? So it means it is a high pass filter. Low frequency attenuated, high frequency is allowed, and therefore it is acts as a high pass filter. So this filter, the circuit what is given here will act as a high pass filter, and the value of R1 will be 100K, R2 will be 1 mega ohm, and capacitor, you can get the value from the cutoff frequency formula 1 by 2 pi R2C. Hope you are able to get it. Any doubt? Getting the answers? Okay. So with this, we'll wind off this session, okay, filters. And in the next gate class, we'll be discussing about current mirrors. Okay, so we'll discuss the concept of current mirrors, and after completing all these things, we'll have some of the gate problems solved. Okay, so next class, we'll see current mirrors. Okay, thank you. Thank you, students.